know what to do for getting all these 6 Bs. Start, let us start. Agar 3 P are required. First, what is required? Prayer is required. What is prayer is not muttering of the word. I merge my dinta, my helplessness with his infinite power. Merging of my helplessness with his infinite power is called prayer. The process through which get a conduit, through which my words go to him and his grace comes to me. He becomes a hearer. Prayer is not begging, our Gurudev used to say. I find a conduit to that through the medium of mantra. Rudra, please hear. Prayer is not an option. And I tell you, there is no one in the world who has not prayed. American, Italian, Russian, Mexico, Spanish, anybody. He may say, I don't believe, but he believes more because he thinks a lot. Those who think, those who say, no, I don't believe in God, they remember God a lot. Because they have to put effort to refute every time. Prayer is required. It is intelligent living that if I am helpless, let me go to the one who has that thing, at least try. And prayer doesn't come, we have to praise the Lord. Praising is one thing which, and please note, we cannot praise the God, because whatever you will say is bigger than that. He says, oh Bhagavan, oh omniscient God, what we know about omniscient? Bole, all knowing. All means what? You know all. You know all. Our prayer is always short. It is not really, we cannot praise him. Because whatever you will say, he is much, Bole, he knows everything. What is everything? Do you know what everything is? Then you can tell that he knows everything. We don't know everything also. He is much bigger than whatever you will praise. It is like, you know, the child saying to the gymnast champion of, the Olympic champion of a weightlifter, my father can lift a cup. Because he could not lift. He is much bigger than that. He can lift Govardhan like this. He can dance on Kalia also. Here grass snake will run away. वो हमको पता नहीं है भगवान के बारे में. Therefore we chant Rudra, it is very good. But let us bring some depth in our sadhana. More shreyo hi jnanam abhyasat. Jnanat dhyanam vishishyate. So first P was prayer. Prayer. Second is? Praise. Without praise, husband won't love wife. I tell you, yesterday I was telling. If husband doesn't praise the wife, wife won't be happy. However good you may be, somebody has to praise you to get your mind. When you praise, praise is a ladder. His heart melts and his glory comes in my heart. Two-way traffic. His glory comes in my heart and therefore Bhagavad is full of praises. Ramayana is full of praises. It is attention getter, not seeker. It gets your attention. If supposing somebody is praising you there, and somebody is saying that person is praising you, naturally you would like to go there. Or at least you will ask, kya kare? And he said, nahin, nahin, nothing. Will he not tell me what it was? And he says, no, you are a very good person. Then he will say, about more. So if you know somebody is praising and you are here, you cannot concentrate after that. If somebody is talking very good about there outside, you cannot sit here. You want to hear that. So this vritti is coming from the God only. If he is praising from the heart, of course. A snake came in the house. Don't think he has one way. Somebody was somewhere saying, headache starts. No, somebody is there. You know, memory comes after 11 o'clock. Memory comes at 11 o'clock. 6 o'clock it goes away. Then again 7 o'clock, 11 o'clock it comes. You don't know what diseases are there. You don't know which person will come to disturb you. Bhagwan chooses a jeev around you. Well, this jeev is good. He speaks very harshly because he has done some bad work. Now let a harsh speaking jeev be around him. Chalo, go. How many years? 30, 40 years. Maro. For a small thing, he'll be upset. Wife will ask him, listen, you will have tea? He said, yes. How many sugar to put? Put me. Married for 25 years. You are asking the question. No, but because you went for diabetic test. No, therefore I'm asking. Why are you shouting? I'm not shouting. I'm telling you. Is this the way to talk? Huh? Then what are you talking? Okay, don't make them going out. I've already made it. No, you drink that. I'm going out. Small, small things he gets. Highly inflammable. It is his anger who is expressing. You know that? He knows all my action of many births. Bahuni me vetitani janmani tava charjanam tanyaham ved sarmani natvam vetap parandapa. Kya baat karta? I know everything about that. And therefore his anger is there towards a certain action. I mean, not whole. But I quieten your anger, please. Namaste to that anger. Quieten. Oh, namaste Rudra mani. Hey, Rudra. Huh? Namaste. What? To that anger. Utota ishave namaha. You have arrows you want to shoot at me. Arrows means the way through which he will give punishment. He is a chastiser. Please namaste to that arrow. Quieten it. I told you namaste is a big power. If you are angry on anybody, he just bows down to you and touches your feet for 2 minutes, 3 minutes, your anger will come down. Sometimes when I shout on somebody, the person does like that. I can't be angry after that also. Lagta hai, kyun? Chalo, utho, chalo. It's okay, chalo. Well, I will not do the same mistake. That means you'll do something else. Oh, namaste Rudra Manyava Utota Ishave Namaha. Then he says, namaste astu dhanvane. Namaskar to that dhanush. All fourth case. Dhanvare, to that bow that you are having. Bow means the means through which you will give me some problem. We are very happy. You don't know what things will come up. And therefore, this is prayaschit. This rudram is used for prayaschit also. Heavy prayaschit mantras are there. Yesterday I told you, yo shatrudriya madhite sa brahma papat puto bhavati brahmatyat puto bhavati kritakritat puto bhavati surapanat puto bhavati. Even if somebody has killed a brahmin or father mother also, after chanting this he can become quiet. But it quietens Lord a lot. It's a quietener. Namaste astu dhanvane bahubhyam. To both your hands I offer my namaskar. Bahubhyam. This is dvitiya, it is called divachan. Fourth case divachan. Namaha. Then he says, yata ishu shivatama. Now what happened? Bhagwan became quiet. So ishu. Ishu, not the English ishu. Here ishu means arrow. So, yate ishu. And shivatama, shivam babuva, that it has become quietened now. So Bhagwan, when he saw his chanting, do namaskar, slowly his arrow and bow, who was like this, it came down. He became little quietened. Ye power in namaskar ki. Therefore it is called namakam. Next will be chamakam. Chame, chame, chame. Nama nama word is there. Nama nama bolti chale ja rahe. So yata ishu shivatama shivam babhuva. This is one sentence. Then it said, te dhanuhu shivam babhuva. Shiv, ye babhu har jagah laga dijiye. De Dhanu, your anger, your arrow also, I mean, your bow also has become quieted now. Let it become auspicious. Shiva Sharavya. Sharavya means quiver. Tarkash. Quiver. Let your Shiva. Shiva means let it become auspicious. So that hand which is about to send something, it has that form has become quietened form now. Like your anger goes away if somebody admits his mistake. And he promises, I won't do it. Please forgive me. His anger also goes away. He will say, you know, can we remove our prarabdh? At least you can dilute it. Then he says, Shiva Shravya Yatavataya No Mrida Rudra Mrida. Hey Rudra. Again the Rudra Agya. Hey Rudra. Mridaya. Mridaya means remain happy. Make us happy. Aise nahi aap naraaz ho gaye. Please be happy. Remember first P? Aap pehle quiet and raho. We should not burn the same bed in which we have to sleep. Not make in the soul the same vessel where I have to eat every day. The same Lord we have who has to give everything, I should not make him upset about something. The same Guru who he has to give me knowledge, not to upset that Guru also. So next, is it clear? Because if Lord is happy, then you can be happy. You know what is the meaning of Lord's happiness? You can't say. What is the meaning of Lord's happiness? How do you know why Lord is happy? You are feeling fulfilled or not inside. Somebody organized a talk somewhere, Secret of Success, for the youngsters. So I first line I said, please don't be after success. All the organizers saw, they thought, but Swamiji has not slept properly. I said, be after fulfillment. Success will be byproduct. There are great people, there are big people. Some who attain big money, big power, they are big people. Great people are not after outer things. We are after inner thing. Bale bas I have sung for myself. Kaisa laga? I felt very happy. How do you know? There is someone inside. He talks. Are he talks, he shouts, he admonishes. When you start seeking inner appreciation, then you become a seeker. I did jab, but I didn't do it properly. How do you know? Achha hi laga. I did very fast. Mridaya, please be happy upon me. Yate Rudra Shiva Tanuru Ghora Papakashini. Yeh toh ho gaya. Yate Ishu Shivatama Shivam Babuvate Dhanu. Shiva Shravya Yatav Tayanu Rudmi. Ho gaya yahan tak. If Bhagwan is not happy, not only inside will be a problem, outside also will be a problem. You will struggle a lot. You will be a sad person. That means some action is not good. Kuch garbad ho gayi baat. Some intentions are not very nice. And sometimes when you continue not good actions, it becomes the nature. It appears right. Wrong thing done repeatedly appears right. Because sensitivity is lost. First cigarette one who smokes, he is very conscious. Mother should not know, father should not know. 20th cigarette, he is not that conscious. He will... In the house also he was not starting. Now he goes in the bathroom, he has the cigarette in the bathroom. And 100 cigarette he can smoke in front of parents also. A person is how much he is sensitive to the higher. So Mridaya, to be sensitive to the Lord is happy on this issue or not? Nahi. Why? Something I did wrong today. What you did wrong? Arey, I was just lying down. My sleep was over, it still I was lying down. Therefore, Vivekananda has to say, arise awake. Uttisht jagrat. Next, let us see the third verse. Please repeat after me.
याते रुद्र शिवा तनूर घोरा, याते रुद्र शिवा तनूर घोरा पाप काशिनी, तया नस्तनवा शंतमया गिरिशंता बिचा कशी, अगेन शैल वी रीड इट, याते रुद्र शिवा तनूर घोरा पाप काशिनी, तयानस्तनवा शंतमया गिरिशंता बिचा कशी, याते रुद्र, अगेन रुद्र, विच केस, वोकेटिव केस, सेवन केसेस आर देयर, नॉट द कोर्ट केस, दिस इज फर्स्ट सेकेंड थर्ड केस, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड विभक्ति इन संस्कृत, प्रथमा द्वितीया एक्सेट्रा, लिटिल लिटिल आई एम टेम्प्टिंग यू, tempting. So Sanskrit peeps and I can't resist, it is so beautiful. He Rudra, yate shiva tanuhu, your form is very auspicious, you have become quieted now. Remain quiet like that. Kisi se bolo to tum quiet ho jao, hum to Bhagwan se kehte bhi nahi ki you quiet, quiet ho jao. We don't say to God be happy also. And if he is not happy, at least he will tell what is my problem, why I am not happy. We don't talk to God also. Our relationship is not good. You know how do you know somebody's relation is dense and thick? You feel like talking a lot. When you don't feel like conversing a lot, that means relation is not very good. And therefore when you are upset, we say, I will not talk to you now. Hum baatein nahi karenge tumse. Jao. Again they start, husband, wife, this happens. So this I will not talk to you. Again they go here and there, again they say, sometimes they are hiding from each other and they see each other. Again they will say sorry, again start. So yate rudra shiva tanu, oh lord shiva, what is that tanu aghora, it is non frightening. I was so frightened, you know, Lord, you are with arrow and bow. And sometimes you feel God is really angry upon me. You can make it out. You can make in your life little sensitivity, who is upset, who is happy. It doesn't need a big PhD studies. Husband is happy with me, wife is happy with me, child is happy with me. In-laws will never be happy. So, they are happy with me, unhappy with me, we can find it out. So if you want to find out, you can find out whether God is happy with me or not. So yatir, now aghora, aghora means non-frightening form you have now. And then apapakashini, very nice word is there. It is apap, because our avsarga is there, a is there. So apap kashini means it will reveal the self. That form of your is your prasanna, then all P will follow, all five P will come. Like if you like the talk, suppose it, and you go to somebody whom you love a lot, then what do you say? Come. Supposing them, I'm not saying you should like. Supposing you like, then you will say, please come. I'll give you one gist. Sometimes they go to the house and they start what their notes they've taken, they tell to somebody. Why? Because you like a lot. You say, I'm telling you very something very good.